Cadets, Dr. Cook here for MS-200. Today we're going to be talking about and SITTEMP portions of enemy analysis. All right, so the next thing we're going to have to produce is called a SITTEMP. All right, this is an overlay. All right, so the first thing you got to start out putting on there is your basic overlay info, like the unclassifieds, all that little index info down in the bottom with the date, time, group, when it was made, who made it, what it's of, a title, that kind of stuff, your north-seeking arrow and your two crosshairs to be able to place it on the map. All right, so we got to get that down because we're doing an overlay. And then after that, we're going to put down enemy unit icons. All right, and we want them down to the team level. So if we're doing a platoon op order, we got down to the team, enemy team level, where do we think those units are? All right, so you can see on this map, there's three little enemy teams out there. All right, where do we think they're going to go? And then we got to have the symbol for the tactical task that they're going to do. All right, so you can see on here, we've got a task around each of them, whether they're screening or trying to destroy or secure an area. All right. And then we're going to put down their key weapon systems. All right, we're going to put those icons. We don't just put them there, but the orientation actually matters. So we want to show where they're located and which way they're pointed to shape the battlefield. Where do we think they're going to put those weapons? Which again comes back to where would I put them if I was trying to do that mission? All right. And then range rings is an optional thing, but it really helps you out. Okay. So based on where I put the machine gun and which kind it is, what is the range, I can draw a big circle around that, because that'll give me some idea of where they can reach with that, so that when I'm planning my mission, I can plan routes that might stay outside of those zones, or I know when I'm moving inside of their capabilities and when I'm outside of it, right? That might be a good spot for phase line, or it might have something to do with how I want to conduct my operations. But knowing that is a good thing to put on there, especially for some of the key bigger weapon systems. It can get real cluttered if you put every single individual weapon, but the key ones that might impact you, you might want to put that. And then the last thing is this task and purpose written out, right? So for their team, that's the decisive operation. Their task is to secure, purpose, prevent us from crossing the bridge, right? And then supporting operation one, their task and purpose, supporting operation two, their task and purpose, right? So we don't just have the symbol for the task, but we can specify the task and purpose goes along. We just write that up on the side somewhere out of the way and record that. All right, so here's the scenario that I'm giving you. The map can get downloaded on the entry pass folder in full 8.5 by 11 size. All right, but basically we're talking about a large enemy force somewhere off to the east off this map. All right, there's a squad that's been tasked to block in this vicinity, all right, along that 1-5 grid line between the two hills here. All right, and then they're there to prevent friendly forces coming from the west. All right, that's our platoon, coming through this avenue of approach between the two hills. All right, now doctrinally, all right, I've given you a task org here for that enemy squad. It's got 9 personnel total, 3 fire teams. All right, there's a squad leader leading team A, there's an assistant squad leader, a deputy squad leader leading team B, and then there's a designated team leader for team C. All right, and the weapons breakout is there. All right, A has got a machine gun in it, B has got an anti-tank RPG launcher in it, and then C has got the grenade launcher in it. Now, intel from the S2 says they're coming off of a recent attack, and this squad is at 77% strength. All right, so you're going to have to factor that in, that they're not full of strength. All right, and then intel also suggests that there's a PCAM machine gun that's been attached to this squad. All right, so consider that as an attachment to beef them up on top of their losses. All right, so go ahead, take that information and apply what you've learned for enemy analysis, and then do an enemy SITTEMP of this sector and bring that to class on an overlay sheet. All right, so that concludes the lecture. I hope you learned something. See you in class.